want you to go home singing this. I will remain confident in this. I will see the goodness of the Lord. Come on, you say it. I will remain confident in this. I will see.
Most righteous and eternal Father God, we just thank you, Lord. We just worship you, Lord. We just honor your presence, God, because you are God alone. You are the God who sits upon the throne. And Father God, Lord, I thank you that we are able to meet here, Lord, on virtual church this Sunday. Father God, we thank you we are able to meet yet another time to be in your presence, Father God, though we are in our homes, Father God. Oh, Father God, so Lord, I thank you, God. I honor you, Lord. I cover this service under your blood. Oh God, I cover the musicians. Oh God, I cover the choristers, Father God. I cover the praise and worship team. Oh God, I cover the bishop, Father God. I cover each and every single life, Father God, that is watching today, Lord. We just thank you, God. We just honor you. We just give you all the praise that is due unto you, Father God. Lord, I thank you in no other name but your precious name. Amen.
Grace Deliverance Tabernacle, deliverance for all.
Just worship right where you are. If you know it, sing along. Lift up the hearts, the lights. A blessing. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I am free. such a blessing. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I am free.
Come on, sing it.
I am free. Praise the Lord. I am free. No longer bound. No more chains holding me. My soul is resting in such a blessing. Praise the Lord, hallelujah, I am free.
Come on, sing that song.
I am free. Praise the Lord, I am free.
Loose yourself.
No longer bound.
No more shackles, no more
no
chains.
More
we are free indeed this
my
day. For Christ's sake, he set us free.
Praise the Lord, hallelujah, I am free.
One more time.
I am free. Praise the Lord,
I feel like
free.
Running,
no longer
I feel
bound.
Like jumping, I feel like skipping,
no
for what the Lord
me.
Has done for
my
me, I was bound and chained in the mire of sin,
but praise the Lord, hallelujah, I am free,
my soul is resting,
it's such a blessing,
it's such a blessing,
praise the Lord, hallelujah, I am free.
Soul is resting,
my soul is resting. It's such a blessing. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I am free.
Hallelujah. We are free. We are free indeed. In Jesus' name, we are free. Somebody help me bless the Lord in this place. Bless the Lord, all my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise will forever be in my mouth. From the rising of the sun to the setting of the day. Oh, I don't hear you guys. God is worthy. Jehovah is worthy to be praised. The name of the Lord, it is a strong tower. The righteous run in this day, and we are saved. Oh, bless the Lord in this place. Right where you are, bless the Lord in this place. We worship the eternal God. He is faithful. He is just. Jude said he is the only wise God. To him be both glory, honor, dominion, and power. We bless the Lord in this place. Hallelujah. It doesn't matter what storm clouds have come to rock this ship of ours. We will rest in the eye of the storm. We will bless the Lord at all times. I said at all times. I said at all times. We will bless the Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. We give you praise. Yes, God, we give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. Worship your holy name. You have done great things. We bless your holy name, God. If it wasn't for you, where would we be? What would we be this day? Worship.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh, my soul, worship your holy name. Sing like never.
goodness is running.
Your goodness is running after. It's running after me. Your goodness is running after. It's running after me.
I lay down my life. I surrender now. I'll give you everything.
Your goodness is running after. It's running after me.
Welcome to Grace Deliverance Tabernacle. At our church, we love to worship.
There can never be enough praise in this house.
At our church, we bring the Bible to life. At our church, the children are the future. At our church, we love to have fun just as much as we love to pray. At our church, deliverance and healing is our goal. Come, let's get ready to worship King Jesus. Welcome to Grace Deliverance Tabernacle. We are so glad you joined us today. Grace Deliverance Tabernacle, deliverance for all.
Expecting my miracle any day now, any day now. I'm expecting my miracle any day now, any day now. I shall
Good morning, blessed people of God, beloved people of God. I greet you this morning in the matchless name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who is head of my life. I am Evangelist Diane Thomas, and I would like to welcome you to the segment of our service entitled Sermon Notes. And today, the topic for the Sermon Notes is by faith. The scripture for this topic will be taken from the book of Hebrews, chapter 11, verse 28. If you have your Bibles, I'd like to invite you to join me now as it reads. Through faith, he kept the Passover and the sprinkling of blood, lest he that destroyed the firstborn should touch them. Whenever the word faith is referenced, there are three scriptures that immediately come to my mind. And that is Hebrews 11 and 1. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Hebrews 11 and 6. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. And Romans 1 and 17. The just shall live by faith. So in order to activate God's divine intervention, we must walk by faith. Faith makes the impossible possible. The children of Israel entered a season known as the Passover, and God made it very clear that this was their season of deliverance. He earmarked this particular moment in time as the Exodus. So the children of Israel entered a supernatural season with God. Now, Moses was given specific instructions that were designed to bring about the intended results, but they had to be activated by faith. From God's point of view, when he gave Moses the plan was marked with victory. And so Moses was required to persevere as he executed the plan by faith. And why was this? Because after Moses would execute the judgment of God, plague 1 through 9, there would still be resistance and opposition from Israel's taskmaster. So although God had earmarked this season, this moment as the Exodus, it still required them to walk by faith. The season was a multi-purpose one, because woven within the judgment that God brought upon the land of Egypt was also a set of faith-building exercises that he would be taking the children of Israel through. See, God's ways are not our ways, and so God desired to demonstrate his power over the evil in the land. He planned on dealing with Israel's enemies, and it would require them to cooperate by faith. So when God sent the plagues into the land of Egypt, what he actually did was he launched an attack against Egypt's economy and their resources. And so plague 1 through 9 would set in motion the final blow that would release his people from bondage. See, plague number 10 would hit Egypt's posterity, and it would bring about God's plan for his people to walk into the promised land. But God also knew when the final judgment would come upon the land of Egypt, it would also touch his people. And so God made provision in the blood of a lamb, and he preserved Israel's posterity according to the promise that he made with their forefathers. See, the Passover was a supernatural occurrence, and it could only be activated by faith. The children of Israel could only activate the provision of a blood covering by faith. The Passover represented God's mercy, the atonement of their sins, and a covenant of new life. And the only way that they could receive this from God was by faith. The promises of God, the promises that he made to his people, the children of Israel, they were not given with perfect conditions. But God promised Israel his provision and victory over their enemies. And so, by faith, Moses did not abort his assignment. By faith, Moses persevered until the plan of God was completed. By faith, the children of Israel received their deliverance. By faith, the children of Israel received their inheritance. If the children of God, the children of Israel, did not cooperate with God's plan, they would not have escaped the final judgment. It was the blood, and by the blood only, that they were able to escape the final judgment when the death angel came upon the land. Beloved people of God, when God gives us instructions to follow by faith, when we follow those instructions, only then will we see our success and our progress. By faith, we too shall get to the other side of our this. Grace and peace be unto you today, beloved people of God. Please receive Dr. Bishop Mervin Harding as he takes us further into the service. God bless you.
Good afternoon, good afternoon to one and all. Welcome, welcome, welcome to Grace Deliverance Virtual Worship Service. Happy, happy Sunday to one and all. I am Bishop Dr. Mervin Harding, Senior Pastor of Grace Deliverance Church of God. We are located at 650 Remsen Avenue in Brooklyn, New York, at the corner of Avenue A. We thank God for the Pentecostal power, the resurrection power, the life-changing power, the soul-saving power. And we truly want to thank our praise team yet for another excellent, excellent job. We truly want to thank those who have prayed, Sister Diane Thomas, for the sermon notes, a great word of encouragement. We give God thanks for this wonderful month of July that we are in, and we are in the great series of Faith versus the Fire. Faith versus the fire, and as Sister Diane noted, that today we are focusing upon by faith. We are focusing upon by faith. So here we take a look at the word of the Lord. I know she had already read a few verses from Hebrews chapter 11, and I'm going to add to what she has already read. By faith, the 24th verse of Hebrews chapter 11 said, by faith, when he was come to years, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter, choosing rather to suffer affliction with the people of God than to enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season, esteeming the reproach of Christ greater riches than the treasures in Egypt, for he had respect unto the recompense of the reward. By faith he forsook Egypt, not fearing the wrath of the king, for he has endured as seeing him who is invisible. Through faith he kept the Passover and the sprinkling of blood, lest he that destroyed the firstborn should touch them. By faith they passed through the Red Sea as by dry land, which the Egyptians, as saying to do, were drowned. The word of the Lord comes to us today from Hebrews chapter 11, the 24th to the 29th verse. And today we are truly excited for another great day that the Lord has given unto us in a virtual church. As you all are well aware that the pandemic is not over, and we are seeing what is happening in other states and in other countries. The Lord has been gracious to us on this side where we are in New York at this particular time, but we ought to be extremely, extremely cautious and careful, because we have had our experience already. Now we see a great Bible character before us today, a man by the name of Moses, a man that the Bible described him as a very, very special figure in the Bible. The Bible said his birth was kind of a different, because he was born under the time when Pharaoh was killing the babies, the male children in Egypt, all because of jealousy, all because of envy, all because of their progress, all because of their success. So let me call to mind and remind somebody today that if you are blessed, if you are progressive, and if you are successful, it is that you are being targeted by your Pharaoh. And I realize that each of us, we have a Pharaoh that we have to deal with, a Pharaoh that we have to face. A Pharaoh, he is searching for us to destroy us, because that Pharaoh knows that we have great calling and great potential upon our lives. That Pharaoh knows that we have a bright future ahead of us. So that Pharaoh is determined to short circuit the plan to destroy us, so that which God has in store for us will not be materialized or fulfilled. But I have good news today for one and all, because our Pharaoh day has come. Our Pharaoh day has come. It might have taken long. It might have seemed forever. It might have seemed that nothing could have moved Pharaoh. With all the great plagues, with all the great visitation of God upon Egypt and upon the people, Pharaoh refused to let God's people go. When we look at the character of Moses, the Bible said he was hid in the basket, and he was placed in the river Nile. He was taken out of the river by Pharaoh's own daughter. He was brought home to Pharaoh's house, to Pharaoh's palace. Pharaoh's daughter claimed him to be her own child. But there was something different about Moses. He was not of the descendants of Ishmael, but he was of the descendants of Isaac. He identified and he recognized what descendants he was from, what tribe he was from. And point to be noted here today that the two tribes that we are looking on, the Egyptians and the Hebrews, the Ishmaelites and the Hebrews, one is in reference to the world, one symbolizes the world, and one symbolizes the kingdom of God. One symbolizes the flesh, and one symbolizes the spirit. So what was happening here is that Pharaoh's daughter wanted to claim Moses to be her own child. Now Moses recognized and Moses acknowledged that if he had accepted the offer to become Pharaoh's daughter, the son of Pharaoh's daughter, Moses recognized that he would have been switching sides. The Bible said when he was come to years of accountability, he was given a great opportunity. He was given a choice, probably to sit on the throne in Egypt, to become one of the pharaohs in Egypt. But Moses understood well who he was, what tribe he belonged to. And the Bible said Moses made a constructive decision to refuse the offer to become the daughter, the son of Pharaoh's daughter. We ought to understand that the world that we are living in, it is a world that is filled with offers. It is a world that is always offering things to trap us and to trick us out of our inheritance and out of our blessing. We could go back to Jesus in St. Matthew when he was led of the Spirit to be tempted by the devil upon the mountains. That three great offers was presented to Jesus, but he refused them all. So the Bible said Moses refused to be called. Don't call me that. I'm not an Ishmael, an Ishmaelite. I am not an Egyptian. I am a Hebrew. Don't call me your son. I don't want to be your son. You see, the real problems and the real issue that we are having, in particular in the church, is that folks love to fit in. Folks love to get recognition. Folks love to be in the limelight. Folks love to be called great and powerful and mighty. Moses saw the offer to fit in Egypt, to become a great state man in Egypt. But the Bible said Moses did not want to fit into Egypt. The things of Egypt, the people of Egypt, Moses did not want to sit on Pharaoh's throne, because Moses recognized that God's throne was greater than the throne of Pharaoh. You see, because we are short-sighted and we can only see but so far, we cannot see the bright future which is ahead. We cannot see the things that are lasting. We cannot see the things that are can only see the things that are now. We can only see the things that have been offered now. But we cannot see the greater offer that God is making us down the road. So as a result, we settle. As a result, we fit in. As a result, we compromise. When we are on the job, we will do everything possible to fit in, to be like those who are on the job. When we are among our friends and our associates, we will do everything possible to fit in, to act like them, to dress like them, to talk like them, to behave like them. We just want to fit in and be in the crowd. But Moses, realizing that his calling and his birth was different from the calling and the birth of the Egyptians, so Moses said, no, I don't want to be called your son. I don't want to fit in Egypt. I am a Hebrew, and I want to remain a Hebrew. Moses stood by faith. His faith was thrown in the fire. But Moses has a fireproof faith. Moses has a faith that the fire could not change or destroy. Moses has a faith that the fire only made stronger. That was why God was able to appear to him in the burning bush. That was why God was able to show him the bush burning, but not been burnt up. Moses was the bush. The fire was burning on him, but he was not burnt up. Oh, that somebody would understand today that the faith in us makes us the bush of God. The faith in us makes us to be the tree of God. So it doesn't matter what fire may be kindling or what fire may be burning up on us. The faith within us makes us to be fireproof. That's why the Bible said when we pass through the fire, we will not be burned, or the flame may kindle upon us. We will not be consumed. This was what the three Hebrew boys knew, that they were fireproof because of the faith that they had in God. They knew that they were God trees. So even though the fire may be burning, they will not be consumed. That's what the Bible said. Moses saw the bush burning, but it was not consumed. The fire was upon the bush, but the bush was not consumed. And I am saying to somebody today who is in the fire, who is in the flame, let not your heart be troubled. Be not be afraid. God has already established and declared that your faith will make you fireproof. You will come out as pure gold. You will come out more than conquerors. You will come out with your head lifted up above your enemies round about you. Let me get back to Moses. For the Bible said, when he was come to years of countability, he refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter, choosing rather to suffer affliction with the people of God than to enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season. Here the real problem, and here the real issues that Christians are facing, is that we want to be a part of what is happening. We want to fit in. We want to enjoy what is happening around us. We want to enjoy the joke. We want to laugh with everybody else. Yet it is not a clean joke. It is not a good joke. It is a joke that you should not be laughing about, but because you want to fit in and you want to be like everybody else, you got to laugh anyhow. You got to agree anyhow, even though you know it is wrong, but you are agreeing to save face. God is looking for a Moses-like people, a Moses-type people, a people that will not fit in to the world, a people that will not pattern themselves after the world, but a people that will stand flat-footed in the righteousness and in the holiness of God in the midst of great criticism, in the midst of great challenges. God is looking for a people who will stand up and hold up the bloodstained banner and keep their wedding garment on, that somebody will see and somebody will know that I am a child of God. I am a Hebrew. I am not an Egyptian. I am different, and I am a difference maker, not to fit in. For he chose rather to suffer affliction with the people of God than to enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season, esteeming the reproach of Christ greater riches than the treasures in Egypt. Moses recognized that Pharaoh's daughter was good, her offer was good. Let me even go further, I said her offer was great, but Moses was looking beyond her offer. Moses was looking beyond the glittering. He was looking beyond the gold. He was looking ahead. He was looking into the future. He was looking at what God has in store for him if he will remain faithful to God, if he will remain true to God, if he will identify himself with God's people and stay with God's people. He recognized and acknowledged, as we have seen many of God's people, because of the offer today, they have become political rather than being spiritual, because of the offer, because of the checks that have been handed out, because of the opportunities that presented themselves. God's people has sold out his church, sold out his righteousness, sold out his holiness, and become political, even though we know that it's wrong and we see the evil and we see the wickedness, but we have to support it because. But Moses said no to the offer. Moses rejected the offer. Moses said it is wrong to accept the offer. I refuse to become political for Pharaoh's daughter want to pull Moses into Egypt's politics for him to become political. But Moses rejected the offer. Moses said, I choose rather to suffer affliction with the people of God, esteeming the reproach of Christ greater riches than the treasures in Egypt. Treasures are now being offered. Treasures are now being presented. Treasures are now being handed out. And many of God's people are going after the treasures, going for the treasures, like Gehazi, chasing after Naaman, chasing for the garment, chasing for the gold. And the Bible said, as Gehazi left the prophet Elijah's house, go chasing after that which Elijah reject, that which Elijah refused, Gehazi went chasing after it, took it from Naaman, brought it back into the house of the prophet. The prophet asked him, where were you? hear my master. And the prophet Elisha said, did not my spirit follow you when you went chasing after Naaman? When you took the garment, when you took the gold, when you took the silver, when you brought it in my house, did not my spirit follow you? I stop by to say to somebody today that the Lord said his spirit has followed his church. His spirit has followed his people. His spirit has followed them into the corruption. His spirit has followed them into the political game. His spirit has followed them into the mess. And he said, that's the reason why I gotta shut the doors of my church. I gotta bring pandemic upon the land because my people settled for the Babylonian garment and the wedge of gold. My people settled for the riches of Egypt, the treasure of Egypt. We see the evil. We acknowledge the evil. We recognize the evil. But because of the treasures, we got to settle to defend and protect the evil and fit in with the evil because of the treasures. But the Bible said Moses rejected the treasures. Moses forsook the treasures. Moses esteemed the treasures of God's greater riches than the treasures of Egypt, because there was a faith in Moses to please God. A faith that connect him, a faith that relate him to God. By faith he forsook Egypt, not fearing the wrath of the king, for he endured as seeing him who is invisible. By faith he turned down the offer. By faith he didn't care how the king feel or what the king has to say. I am staying on God's side. I am staying with the righteousness. Let me suffer, but I'm staying with the righteousness. I'm staying with the holiness. I'm staying with the principles. I'm staying with the righteousness. I'm staying with the godliness. I will not sell out my people. I will not sell out my integrity or my character for the treasures that have been handed out. I will stand, having done all to stand. Oh, glory to God. Rabbi Kalabosha. I will stand flat-footed. I will stand alone. I will stand by faith. I will go through. I will suffer. I rather suffer affliction with the people of God than to enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season. By faith he esteemed the reproach of Christ greater riches than the treasures in Egypt, for he had respect unto the recompense of reward. The real issues that we are having is that most people don't have respect for the reward anymore. Most people are not seeing the reward. They are seeing the treasure. They are seeing the riches. They are seeing the opportunity. They are seeing the handout. They are not seeing the importance of holding up the bloodstained banner of defending the truth, of crying out against wicked and ungodly systems, in crying out against hatred and racism. Many people are not seeing that as the great value. Many people are not seeing that is important. Many people are not seeing that we have been sold out. But God is looking for a people like Moses who will have respect unto the recompense of the reward, who know that what lies ahead is a whole lot greater than what is currently being offered. What lies ahead. He's a whole lot greater than what it is present. But the Bible said faith is the substance of things not seen, the evidence of things hoped for. We lack the substance. And because we lack the substance, we lost the evidence. Because we lack the substance, we lost the promise. But faith is the evidence, is the evidence, is the substance. And the Bible said, by it the elders obtain a good report. Folks are no longer concerned about God's report. They are more concerned about man's report. They want to be recognized by man. They want to be on man's side. They want man to promote them. They want man to bless them. People are no longer concerned about how God feels, what God is saying about them, what God is recording in their report. But I stop by to say to somebody, as the Bible said, Moses esteemed the report of Christ greater riches than all the treasures in Egypt. Moses knew that what he was giving up was a whole lot less than what he would be gaining down the road if he remained faithful and stayed with the people of God. For by it, the elders obtain a good report, a report of faithfulness, a report of righteousness, a report of godliness, a report in which God was well pleased. What can God say about our report today? The Bible said before Enoch was translated, he had this testimony that he pleased God. What can God say about our report? Can we believe God to fulfill that which he promised that he will do in the future? Hear the truth of the matter. Many people are in it, but they do not believe in it. Let me say that again. Many people are in it, but they do not believe in it. 70% of Christians who pay their tithes and give their offering, they do it because they know it's a requirement, but not that they believe that it will work. And because they don't believe that it will work, they struggle in being faithful in paying their tithe because they are in it, but they do not believe in it. They struggle in offering sacrifice because they are in it, but they do not believe in it. But thank God for the honesty of the man in St. Mark chapter 9, when Jesus said to him, if you can only believe. He said, Lord, I am a believer, but I don't believe in it. I am struggling with some unbelief. Help thou my unbelief. You know I'm telling the truth. You know that you are in it, but you are not fully believing in it. You have some doubt. You have some reservation whether or not God is going to do what he say he will do if you do what he tell you to do. And that is where we are having the struggle. That is where we are having the problem. We are quicker to believe man if man make us a promise than to believe God when God make us a promise. God is looking for a by faith people, a through faith people. By faith, I'm paying my tithes. By faith, I'm giving my offering. By faith, I'm offering my sacrifice. By faith, I'm presenting my body. By faith, I'm walking away from my boyfriend. I'm walking away from my girlfriend. By faith, I'm giving up the ungodly relationship. Even though my support is coming from it, by faith I am giving it up. I'm walking away from it because I have respect unto the recompense of God's greater riches, the reward that God promised me. I am believing for it. I'm sowing for it. I'm laboring for it. And here's the other problem. Here's the other issue. Is that many of us, we only have one hand. We only have one hand. Or we might have had two hands, but we only have one active hand. One hand, as it were, is crippled. One hand is inactive. We only have a receiving hand. I'm not here to hit on preachers or to preach against preachers or to criticize preachers. I would hate to do that. But many preachers have one hand. It doesn't matter how much you will bless them. It doesn't matter how much you will do for them. They only have a hand to receive. They don't have a giving hand. And many people are like that. They only have a receiving hand. They do not have a giving hand. But God gave us two hands. One to give, one to receive. The reason why we remain in our same condition, herein and hereof, is because one hand is inactive. One hand cannot climb. If we are going to climb out, if we are going to climb up, the prophet Habakkuk said, I will climb up on the tower. If we are going to climb up on the tower, we will have to activate both hands. Both hands to worship. Both hands to lift up praises. Both hands to give thanks. One hand to give. One hand to receive. One hand to help. One hand to show mercy. One hand to show goodness. One hand to show favor. We need to activate the both hands and to get the both hands involved. So Habakkuk said, I will climb up on the top of the tower. I will stand up on my watch. I will hear what God the Lord will say to me. Because I realize where I am, I need to go up higher. So he said, I'm going to climb up. I'm calling upon each and every one today. Activate both hands. God gave us two hands. One to give and one to receive. Let us get in it and believe in it. And do what is required in it. So God can bless us in it. God can anoint us in it. God can use us in it. Moses believed in it. Moses got in it. Moses stayed in it. Moses knew what God said in his words he will fulfill. He will do that, even though Moses did not see it for the present, but by faith he believed for it. That somewhere, somehow, down the road, down the line, God would have come through. God would have delivered. God would have blessed. The Bible tells us how. By faith, he forsook Egypt, not fearing the wrath of the king. Through faith, he kept the Passover. The Bible tells us how he slew the Egyptian. Because the Egyptian was messing with the Hebrew. And the Bible tells us how one of his own sold him out. So as a result, he had to run away to the backside of the mountain. He was 40 years. He spent a whole 40 years in the backside of the mountain in hiding because his own sold him out. Isn't that proud spirit still popular and still common among us? Isn't that somebody have to be running and hiding because how we uncover them and rip them apart? How we expose them and embarrass them and put them to shame? They have to run and be in the backside of the mountain hiding. Am I telling the truth that the selling out spirit is still in us and still with us and still in our midst? I need to die. I need to be rebuked. I need to be cast out. I need to be crucified. This selling out spirit, it's time we get rid of it and become one in Christ Jesus our Lord. Holy Ghost, help us. Moses was sold out by his own Hebrew brother. But after 40 years in hiding, he remained faithful, for he had a faith that was fireproof. Because his faith was fireproof, God was able to call him at age 80, a little old man with gray hair and gray beard. God was able to call him and said, I want you to go down to Egypt and tell Pharaoh to let my people go. After 80 years, he was still connected. He was still in it. He was still faithful. He was still righteous. He was still connected with his God. God could have still called him by name, because after 80 years, he had established and built up a good rapport. You faith the elders. Hey. You faith the elders of day. A good report. What is in your report today? Can I see your book? Can I see your report card? Or can I turn the pages and look at what is in your report? When God turned Moses' pages after 80 years, God was able to call Moses to the burning bush. The Bible said God met him. In Exodus chapter 3, the Bible said God met Moses in a place. What place can God meet you in today? Can he meet you in a place of righteousness? Can he meet you in a place of holiness? Can he meet you in a place of truth? Can he meet you in a place of uprightness? The Bible said the unjust knows no sorrow. The unjust knows no mercy. Where can God meet you today? Are you representing the merciful and great high priest? Can God meet you in a place of compassion? After 80 years, Moses was still usable. After 49 years in the church, I have seen a lot and I have learned a lot. And I've learned that many people who was once usable is no longer usable, because they settle for the treasure, they settle for the riches, they settle to fit in. So as a result, they are no longer usable. But I stop by to say to somebody, are you still usable? Can God still call upon you? Can God still call your name? Can God say, this is my beloved son in whom I am well pleased? This is my beloved daughter in whom I am well pleased? What can God say about your report? Are you wrapping up in the things of this world? Are you wrapping up in the treasure? Or are you keeping yourself separated? God called Moses. Send Moses down to Egypt to Pharaoh. Moses was still qualified after 80 years. Went down to Egypt. Declare war upon Pharaoh and Egypt. But here the real issue and the real challenges. After 9 vicious plagues upon Egypt, Now, when we have leaders who don't care about the sufferings of the people, when we have leaders who don't care if plagues are upon the people, when we have leaders see people dying and it doesn't matter, it's not important, then we know it is time to pray, because we know the spirit of Pharaoh is very much alive and reigning and present, because the Bible said with all the nine vicious plagues, with all the punishment, with all the pandemic upon Egypt, with all the pain that families were going through, with all the suffering and the hurt, the Bible said Pharaoh would not move. Pharaoh did not care what was happening to the people. All Pharaoh cared was about himself, the spirit of Pharaoh. But I hear the Holy Ghost say, Pharaoh's day has come. Glory to God. And after Israel watched nine plagues upon Egypt, vicious plagues, and Pharaoh did not budge, the people no longer would believe in Moses. The people no longer would trust Moses. The people were still in it, but they were no longer believing in it. This is where we are in society. This is where we are in the church, that people are still in the church but no longer believing in it. The children of Israel no longer. So when God told Moses, this is the main verse, the closing verse, the final verse, the by faith verse. When God told Moses to keep the Passover, the Bible said Moses faced great challenges, not from the Egyptians, not from the world, not from the Ishmaelites, but from the people in the church, from the Hebrews people, from the believing people. Moses faced great opposition from them. They tell Moses off, they curse Moses off. They said, why do you think this foolish is going to work after the nine plagues that God sent upon Pharaoh and Pharaoh did not budge? Why you think this is going to work? Great opposition, great challenges, great criticism. But the Bible said Moses stood firm. Moses remained firm. Moses kept the Passover. Moses carried out the assignment. Moses did that which thus said the Lord. He kept the Passover and the sprinkling of blood. He did everything that God said to do. And today I said to somebody, doesn't matter how strong Pharaoh may be, doesn't matter how hard Pharaoh may be, doesn't matter how powerful Pharaoh may be, today we sprinkle blood, today we scatter blood, today we dab with blood, today we use blood and cripple and confound and defeat and destroy the house of bondage, the network of evil, of Pharaoh and his kingdom. We blow up by the anointing. The Bible said through faith. While some were saying, look at him. What some were saying is turning crazy and turning mad. What is all this about sprinkling blood? What is all this about putting blood on the doorpost? What is that going to do? Look at all the vicious plagues that took place before, and Pharaoh did not, but nothing happened. But the Bible said, by faith, Moses carried carry out the assignment. Can God find a people today who will move by faith in spite of, despite of, regardless of, and carry out the assignment and carry out the appointment and do that which thus saith the Lord? By faith, in the midst of great challenges, in the midst of great opposition, by faith he kept the Passover and the sprinkling of blood. By faith, Moses, by faith they passed through the Red Sea and dry land. Let me say today, as I wind up this message to climax it, let me say today that God will allow the enemies, and God will let the enemies go as far as they want to go. After Pharaoh survived the 10 plagues, after he survived the killing of the firstborn, for a long time the crying was in the house of the Hebrews. But I hear the Holy Ghost say a switch is in the ear. A shift is in the ear. A turning around is in the ear. For a long, long time, the crying was in the house of the Hebrews. The oppression was in the house of the Hebrews. The hand of the oppressor was upon the Hebrews. But I hear God say, it's time for a switch and time for a shift. Because now the crying was now in the house of the Egyptians. Because God came down. God moved through. God delivered. God loose and set his people free. But God still allowed Pharaoh. For Pharaoh said, I will satisfy my lust and my ego. Pharaoh said, why did we let them go? God will not stop the evil or the wicked one until they go to the extreme. God will allow them to go to the full length of the rope. That is why the Bible said in the 37th Psalm, fret not yourself about the wicked who bring evil devices to pass, because God is allowing them to go to the extreme, to go to the end of the rope, to do as much as they want to do. So Pharaoh said, we will go after them. I will satisfy my lust and my ego upon them. I will release my anger upon them. Why did I let them go? And I say to somebody that even now, the heathen, the enemies, the haters, the demonstrators, the protesters, even now they still believe that they have a chance. Even now they are still working because they still believe that they are going to win. Seems as if they have more faith than us. Seems as if they believe in it more than us, because even now, after all what God has done to them, they still believe that they are going to win. They still believe after all what God did to Pharaoh. Pharaoh still believed that he was going to win the war. So God let Pharaoh and his army, all his chariots and his horses and his riders, for this was, and I hear the Holy Ghost said, this is the final rounding up of your enemies. Rabababa. God is circling your enemies one more time. God is pulling them out of their place one more time. God is allowing them to come up against you one more time. I hear the Holy Ghost said one more time. And I hear the Holy Ghost said, Egyptians that you see today, you will see them no longer. This is the last time. One more time. For it is Pharaoh's day. It is rounding up day. It is destruction day for Pharaoh and his army. One more time, said God. And the Bible said, words got to Pharaoh that they were trapped by the Red Seas. Because your enemy, because of your situations, because of your circumstances, and because of your challenges and your struggles, your enemy has seen you trapped. Your enemy see you as there is no way out for you. Your enemy see you with your back up against the walls. Your enemy see you as an easy target. Your enemy sees you today as being defeated. Pharaoh said they are trapped at the Red Sea and the mountains surround them. Little did Pharaoh know that it was not Israel who was surrounded, but it is him and his army that was surrounded. So God told Moses, stretch your rod across the sea, and Moses did so, and God opened up the sea and the waters. They climb up into a great mountain, and the left and on the right, and God paved a road. Isaiah 35 said, a highway shall be there on the way, and it shall be for the wayfaring. Oh, glory to God, for things which are seen were not made of things which do appear, but they were made by the Spirit of God and the spoken word. And God is saying, get ready for miracles that will blow your mind. Get ready for unexpected doors to be opened and roads to be made and gates to be opened. Get ready for unexpected access that I will give you when it seems that if there's no way out, when it seems that if it's over for you. The writer said, what though in the conflict for right, your enemies have almost prevailed, God's army just hid from their sight are more than the force which assail. Rejoice, rejoice, be glad in the Lord, and rejoice all ye that are upright in heart. Rejoice with harp and organs and voices. The Lord, hallelujah, is prolonged. Rejoice, rejoice, be glad in the Lord and rejoice. Don't wait until you get to the other side to pick up the timbrel. Pick it up now and start singing by faith. Pick it up now and start shouting by faith. Pick it up now and start worshiping by faith. For God has sent you a word that the Egyptian that you see today, you will say, Shababa, you will see them no more. Oh, say the Lord God Jehovah, an instant way. For things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. God did not have to gather asphalt. God did not have to gather trucks. God did not have to gather rollers. God did not have to gather men. All God did was to speak the word, and the Spirit breathed upon the sea. The sea parted. The road was made. God is saying to you today, there's a spoken word over your life that is going to do it for you. You don't have to look to man. You don't have to depend on man. You don't have to sell it out to man. No, you don't have to compromise. You don't have to become political. God said to tell you, my Spirit and my word is enough to do it for you. Believe in it and you will see it. Believe in it and you will receive it. Believe in it and it will come to pass. Oh, said God, an instant way God prepared. Israel was able to sail their way to the other side. And the Bible said the Egyptians are saying to do. The Egyptians saw the way. They enter in the way. For the Bible said in the 37th Psalm, evil pursued the just and seeketh to slay him. And the word pursue means to chase after vigorously. Evil chase down the just vigorously and seek to slay him. But between the just and evil, there's a thing that is called surely goodness and mercy. Following the just all the days of their life, it followed Israel into the Red Sea. It created a division between Pharaoh's army and Israel. He could not caught up with them. And the Bible said after Israel passed, God started to plow up the road. He started to dig up the road because the road was not made for Pharaoh and the Egyptian. It was made for Israel. So the chariot wheel began to get stuck in the road, fall off in the road, broken up in the road. And the Bible said Pharaoh had chosen his best chariots, his best horses, and his best soldiers. He carried his whole army because he was set out to release greater vengeance upon the Hebrews than ever before. When Israel got to the other side, the Bible said that God told Moses, are you still at the place today that God can talk to you? Are you still at the place where you can do what God says to do? Because the real problem many a time, when we reach, we forget to even listen to what God has to say next. When we reach, we refuse to even do anything next because we reach. But when they got to the other side, God was still talking to Moses. Stretch your rod again towards the Red Sea. God is saying to somebody, I need you to listen again. I need you to hear me again. I am not yet finished. Can I get your attention? Can I get another word in? Say, God, can you look at me one more time? Say, God, can you hear what I'm saying from heaven one more time? Can you look away from the pleasures? Can you look away from the politics? Can you look away from the pollutions and look to me by faith one more time? The Bible said that Moses did so. Moses stretched the rod another time because the rod represents the spoken word of God. Thy rod and thy staff, the spirit and the word. The rod was representing the creative word, the destructive word, the consuming word, the two-edged sword word. The rod represents the word, the spirit and the word, the spirit and the bride, the two-edged sword, the rod and the staff. Sharper. The Bible said that any two-edged sword, they work together. As long as the word was declared over the Red Sea had to obey, the Red Sea had to cooperate. And today we declare the word, we pronounce the word of God in the earth over demons and devils and principalities and powers over the wicked, their network and their operation. We pronounce and declare the word that their day of destruction has come, that Pharaoh's day and his army has come. Almighty God, let your word be fulfilled. Let your will be done. Take honor upon Pharaoh and his army this day, God. The Bible said, the sea closed in, and Pharaoh, his chariots, his horses, and his riders, they got to the other side, but they got there as dead bodies. They got to the other side. God will allow the wicked to go as far as they want to go. God will allow them the maximum length of the rope. God will allow them to fulfill their desire and their lust as much as they want to. But today we stand and decree and declare by and through the word of God, by faith, that every evil petition will be denied. Every evil sacrifice will be consumed by fire. Every evil pronunciation and declaration will be destroyed by fire. That none will be fulfilled, that none will come to pass, that none will happen, that the lust of the wicked will never be fulfilled upon God's people. For God is in control, God is in charge, and God is with us. And we walk by faith and not by what we see or what we hear. What is happening? As I close today, I pronounce the priestly blessings of God upon your life, upon your calling, your ministry, and your future. That faith will come alive in you. Faith that will be greater than fire. Faith that fire will not be able to consume. It doesn't matter what fire you may be facing today. Amazing Moses faces a whole lot of fire. But at the end, God was able to testify and talk about his faith. What can God say about your faith? At the end of the day, I pronounce the priestly blessings. I pronounce the glory and I pronounce the grace of God upon you, that you will be strong and be very courageous. For God said, as I was with Moses, so will I be with you, thus saith the Lord. God said, keep your eyes on me and keep on looking up and keep on walking by faith. A faith greater than the fire. Faith that is fireproof, saith God. I'm looking for a people who will not be ashamed to be called their God. I am Bishop Dr. Mervin Harding. The words of the Lord, they are blessed and they are yea and amen. Our First Lady will be coming to do the altar call, the virtual altar call, and to do the prayer for our children, our nations, our people. If ever a time we need to pray, it is now. Each and every one is hereby invited. We are inviting parents and family who have lost loved ones through gun violence to come this evening. We in particular want to pray for you. We want to end the cycle. We want to pray that God will strengthen you and that God will cover your family from any future casualty. If you have children in gangs, we need you to come. We need to pray with you and for you. We are inviting as many people who can join us this evening to come and join with us at 6:50. Remsen Avenue. We are standing on the corner at Remsen Avenue and Avenue A, standing in prayer, standing in faith, standing in the power of the Spirit, standing and believing God, believing it for what he says he will do. God bless you as you keep on believing in it. Have a good afternoon, everybody, and peace be unto you.
We want to bless God. We want to bless God. We want to give God thanks. We want to give God worship. We want to bless God for the servant of God. I know that my heart was blessed. I know that your heart was blessed. Can we set up some hearts for the servant of God? We want to bless God. We want to bless God for the servant of this house. Go ahead and send up your hearts. Go ahead and bless God. Go ahead, because we give God thanks. There is a word that is in our midst. There's a word in our circle. There was a word, a present word, a word that is coming from the portals of glory, and we want to celebrate the man of God. We want to celebrate one that is carrying the word of God. Go ahead and bless God. We want to bless God for the servant. We want to bless God. We want to bless God. Because with us today. We know that we are some fireproof faith. We want to bless God. We want to bless God. We saw it last week. He took us in the ring. And this week, he gave us a fireproof faith. We want to bless God. We want to bless God. We want to have a report that please God. We want to have a report in the mighty name of Jesus. As the word of God reminds us, esteeming the report of Christ greater riches than the treasures of Egypt. We want to bless God. We want to have a report that please God. We want to thank God. It is now time for the altar call, and we want to bless God. You have some prayer requests. You have some things that you're believing God for. Well, I just want to stand in agreement with you. I just want to touch and agree that our God, who is able to do exceedingly abundantly, go ahead and type your prayer requests as we believe God, as we thank God. Hallelujah. Hey, the Spirit of the Lord is at work. The Spirit of the Lord God is in this place. We want to bless God. We want to bless God. We want to bless God. The Word of God, it convicts us. The Word of God, we want to bless God. We want to bless God. What a word. What a word. What a word. What a word. That was a word indeed. That there was a word indeed. Hallelujah. Go ahead. Type your prayer request. Hallelujah. As we trust God, as we bless God, as we bless God, as we give God thanks. Mighty God, mighty God, we were challenged by the word. We were challenged by the word. Sister Nicola Douglas, Sister Nicola Waite, she's requesting prayer for her family. Father, as we go before your Makoto Sakata, I surround her family. I decree and declare, God, that every curse, Makosakata, sever, every curse destroyed, every curse cut off, every plot of the wicked one cut off, Ekata, every assignment, God, every assignment from the kingdom of darkness, everything that seek to come against the family of your servant, be thou destroyed in the name of Jesus. I destroy the works of darkness. I plead the blood of Jesus. And I call for the blood covering. I call for the blood covering. We build up the engine, prayer, God. And declare and declare no weapon. I sever that which seek to attach to the family that is not of you. I bring it to naught. Let God arise and his enemies be scattered. I scatter the enemy, God. And I cover, divine covering, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you even right now. Sister Denise Sylvester, I set blood, sword, and fire. I rebuke the plans of the enemy, and I hear the Spirit of the Lord say, no setback. I come against the spirit of setback that has played. I come against the spirit of setback that has keep you in a standstill, your family in a standstill. I stand in the realms, and I decree and declare clearance that you will receive that which God, the expectation from the kingdom of God. Anamoko, I wrap you for deliverance. I wrap you for breakthrough. And I begin to give God thanks. Anamoko, sekete. Sister Julian Simit, Mako, Make. I go before God. Anamoko, sekete. As you have professed your faith, Akoto, sekete. The Spirit of the Lord said, be it unto you. Akoto, be strengthened to you this day. Eke, sakoto. Makete, sekete. Moko, sakata. In the name of the Lord our God, I call for deliverance. I call for the seed that has been planted. Akoto, because the word of God declares, while man slept, the enemy sow seed and went his way. Akoto, he said, let the wheat and the tears go together until the day of harvest. Eke, seketo. Mighty God, you promised to burn the chaff with fire. Anamoko, seke. And I said, fire to every chaff. Eyanamoko, saka. And I call for the wind of God, Enamoko Saka, to drive out the will and the work of the enemy, that nothing will steal your testimony. I decree and declare it in the name of Jesus. Sisters Taylor, go before God, Enamoko Sekete. Makete yo no moko sekete in the name of Jesus. Akoto se ne moko seke. I set blood, sword, and fire. I go before God for Sister Taylor. Akoto. The word says he teaches your hands to war and your fingers to fight, so that a bow of steel can be broken. I go before God. I stand in the realms. I go to the holies of holies and I set fire. Hey, Akoto. The devil is a liar. Ene moko seke is defeated. Akoto. It shall not come to pass. The devil is a liar and he's a father of lies. I wrap you in the blood, Sister Taylor. I go before God, Sister Faye, Eke, Sana, Moko, Sekete, Makete, Sekete, Moko, Sekete. I lift up Sister Faye before you, God. Akoto, Sekete. I wrap up my house, Eke, Sekete, Moko, Sekete, Aramoko, Sakata. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life, and you will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Akoto, no Moko, Seke. By and through the blood of Jesus, I wage war. I stand in the place of God, I declare it shall not be your portion. I cancel it, I cut it off, I sever it, and send it back to the pit of hell. Every bad news from the kingdom of darkness, I interrupt it and I send it back in the name of Jesus. I speak your deliverance. Sister Michelle Evans, she's asking prayer for her sister Leonie. I destroy. I go before God and I send it back, God, in the name of Jesus. Hey, Father, even right now, mighty God, even right now, her steps you will order. You will order her steps, God, that yea, though she walk to the valley of the shadow of death, she will fear no evil, because you are with her, your rod and your staff. Even right now, I release the presence of God that you will do, God, what no other powers can do. Sister Rochelle Deacon, we're looking ready to close. I go before God. Sister Rochelle said, all I want to say is thank you, God. I wrap her up in the blood. I set fire to every trap, every evil demonstration, everything that is coming up against you. In the name of Jesus, it shall not prevail. I wrap you in the blood. I wrap your mind in the blood. I take you in the presence of God. I take you to the presence. I call for the shift in your atmosphere. Father, Sister Marcia Yearwood, she said, I'd like you to pray for my friend that is having more marital problems. That which was sent to her, God, I go before God. Mighty God, you're the God that came down and troubled the water. Because your word says the man sat at the pool for 38 years. He was there for a long time in that condition. But you are the God who came and restored. You are the God who came and made new. I decree and declare, God, you shall make new. In the name of Jesus, I bless the marriage. And I drive off that which is not of God. You bickering spirit, you murmuring spirit, I curse you by the name of the Lord our God. Sister Joy Stewart Ekata, she said, please pray for guidance as I go day by day, going out and coming in. Father, your angels with flaming swords of fire encamp it round about your daughter. Even right now, God, even right now, in the mighty name of Jesus, I surround her. The word of God said, as the mountains surround Jerusalem, I ask you, God, to surround Sister Joy. I ask you, God, to cover Sister Joy. I ask you, God, to wrap up Sister Joy. Keep Sister Joy, God. Preserve your daughter. Let the hand of the Lord, let the spirit of the Lord, I come against every intimidating spirit, everything that will want to intimidate your servant. I rebuke it. I bind it. I curse it in the name of Jesus. We are closing. Sister Jasmine Shepherd, she said to you, she's asking for prayer, but thank God for coming through for me this past month. Father, and activate your presence like never before. Moses was accustomed to your presence. I decree and declare, God, that Sister Jasmine will be accustomed to your presence. Take her into the holies of holies and begin to reveal yourself that you're the God of more than enough, and you're the God that shall supply all her needs according to your riches in glory by Christ Jesus. Sister Everbest, she said, I need prayer for my household and for me and my husband. Thanking God for allowing to go back to work from tonight. Father, Eke Sakotono Moko Saka. Mane moko sekete yo koto. Maketene moko seketa sakoto. In the mighty name of Jesus, I go before God. He was the one who got up in resurrection power. Mighty God, that our household will never be the same. I speak a shift. I speak a shift in our household, that God will begin to move things. He's the God of order. He created everything in order. I speak order in your house. I release the peace which surpass all human understanding. I wrap your house in peace. Every disobedient spirit, I come against it in the mighty name of Jesus. Hey, I wrap your house in peace. I wrap it in the name of Jesus. Sister Andrea Byfield, she said, I'm having problems with my knee and I'm having to be happy. Father, I plead the blood of Jesus. You're the God who renew. You're the God of miracles. Father, even right now, I pray by and through the blood of Jesus that virtue will come forth from the portals of glory. I call for healing now, God. I call for restoration. I call for, God, that you will make new. Spread your wings, God. Spread your wings over her house. Spread your wings over her family. Spread your wings over her marriage. Spread your wings over her children. In the name of Jesus, Akoto. Sister Simone, she's asking for covering for her niece and nephews. Ana moko sekete, makoto sakata. Mighty God, your word tells us, from the womb you have called them. Ena moko seke. Mighty God, your mark is upon them. Ena moko seke. And every secret trap exposed. Ena moko seke. I go before God. Mako make. I rock Ethan. Makete ne moko seke te sakoto. Makete ne moko sakata. Eyo koto se ne moko se. In the name of the Lord, oh God. Akoto. I interrupt every accident. I block every accident. Ana moko sa. Aya koto seke ne. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pull him out of danger, seen or unseen. I turn it, God. I turn it, and I wrap them in you, God. I wrap them from the plans of the enemy. I wrap them from the agenda of the enemy, God. In the name of Jesus, we want to thank God. We want to bless God. I believe this is the last prayer request from Sister Campbell. She, please pray for my baby Jordan and my family for healing and deliverance. Eka sekete, ma ketene moko saka, ma kono moko seketene moko sekete, ma kete sekene moko saka. In the mighty name of Jesus, ekata, I cancel. I rebuke the plans of the enemy and I cover Jordan. Ana moko sekete. This plot of the enemy will not prevail. This assignment will not prevail. I go before God, ekata sakoto, that thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. I pull down the will of God. I pull down the will of God. I pull it down in the mighty name of Jesus. And I cancel every intended will of the wicked one in the name of Jesus. I call for healing virtue and the power of healing to now flow in your home, upon your life, in the mighty name of Jesus. We want to thank God. This segment has now closed. And we want to bless God. We want to bless God. We want to bless God. We want you to remain, because now is an awesome time. Now is an excited moment. Now is a moment that we are going to give. We're going to sow back in the land. Our Bishop touch, and we are that there's a giving hand and there is a receiving hand. My God, what a word, what a word, what a revelation, what a revelation that is coming forth from the Spirit of God. We have a giving hand and we have a receiving hand, and it is now time to use our giving hand. We want to use our giving hand this hour. We want to use our giving hand this hour, and our methods of giving, it's Cash App. It's Cash App, and it's GDT. It's $ for Cash App, I'm sorry. It's $GDT650. So it's $GDT650. And for Zelle, it's GDT650ADM@AOL.com. And text to give is 844-945-2383. And we can also pick up your tithes upon request. And the number is 718-974-6753. So the number is 718-974-6753. But just before we receive our offering, I just want to read a very famous scripture, one that is well known, Isaiah 40 and verse 31. It's about they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not weary, not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. I don't know what you're waiting on God for, but here that we are now in the service, in our part of service to give, and our God is able to do exceedingly, abundantly. Somehow I did not take my purse with me, but if you have your purse, you have your wallet, go ahead. As we intercede, as we touch and agree today, as we touch and agree today, hey, as we touch today, as we touch and agree today, as we're believing God today, in the name of Jesus, Father, go before you. And as your people, oh God, have extended themselves, oh God, to give, my God, your word says it's better to give than to receive. And we'll be crying out to you, God. We begin to cry out even right now, God, that which has been withheld by the prince of Persia, Akoto. They said, if we wait upon you, God, you will renew our strength. Great God, mighty God, in the name of Jesus, you will cause us to mount up with wings, mighty God, like eagle. I go before God, even though we are waiting, God, it's a season for us to mount up. It's a season for us to soar. I come against every present condition, mighty God, every present situation that we want to sit upon your people, God, that they cannot give, that they will not give. Plead the blood of Jesus. I plead the blood, mighty God. I call for to reverse the flow. I call for financial rivers. Those who you have blessed, God, in this season, that they will see the need to give. They will give, God. Mighty God, the woman with the widows, with the mite. Mighty God, she gave all she had. Mighty God, for those who have given. Our God, they're all. My God, I speak a blessing. I speak a blessing like never before, in the name of Jesus. Father, I want to thank God. I want to bless God. I want to glorify God. As your people give in this season, as they get to the work of God, as they give, almighty God, and good soil, good ground, in Amokosaka, as be pressed down, shaken together, and running over, shall man put in your bosom. We want to thank God. We want to bless God. Today was an awesome day, an awesome day. What a word. Go ahead, share our videos, like our videos. Bless someone hard. You don't want to hold on to this word. This word is rich. This word is rich. This word is rich. You want to share this word. Go ahead, share this word. Bless somebody with this word. The Lord is a good God. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. May he make his face to shine upon you. May he be gracious unto you. I want to bless God. Bless God. Bless the Lord. Have a wonderful day. Have an awesome day. And we want to give God thanks. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance. And the Lord bless you with his peace. Have a wonderful day.
We shall rise again. We will rise again. We will rise again. We will rise again. We'll rise again.
Oh, you took us into the control of the house. There's another one too. We shall rise. I decree that we shall rise. We shall rise again. We shall rise again and declare. All is well. Father, I pray for every listener. I pray for their faith even now. That they won't doubt. They won't quit. Despite what life looks like right now, I decree over their life that they shall rise again. Despite what life looks like and feels like, I decree a resurrection in their life. Oh, fantastic. I decree a resurrection in their life. I decree right now that everything in their life that died prematurely, every dream, every goal, every vision, I breathe. We breathe it back to life. We command life to come back. We decree and declare that you shall rise again. We decree and declare that you shall rise. You shall rise again. We decree and declare you shall. Ho, 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 ho. You shall. You shall. You shall. You shall. You shall. We'll rise again.